Hello and welcome to this episode of the Handshake. My name is Amal Chowdhury, and as the year comes to an end, let's have a look at different foreign policy decisions taken by Narendra Modi government. Bharatiya Janata Party's core political ideology guided Narendra Modi's foreign policy decisions in 2019. For the first time in 50 years, Indian fighter jets attacked terror camps in Pakistan. Modi tried to forge closer ties with the United States and balance ties with China. Here's a look at some of his major geopolitical decisions of the year 2019. February 14, 2019, a car laden with explosives rammed into a CRPF convoy in Pulwama, killing 40 personnel. The attack was carried out by Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed. India launched a diplomatic offensive to expose Pakistan. The UN Security Council strongly condemned the attack. February 26, 2019, Indian Air Force jets crossed the line of control after 47 years and bombed a terrorist training camp in Balakot. The next day, an air-to-air combat took place in which one F-16 was shot down and Indian forces lost a MiG-21 fighter. The pilot wing commander Abhinandan was detained by Pakistani forces. India made it clear that Abhinandan would not be a bargaining chip. United States too intervened through military channels. On March 1st, Pakistan released the Indian pilot. May 30th, 2019. 3 months after the Pulwama attack, Narendra Modi decided to invite BIMSTEC, that is the Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multi-Sectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation, heads of state for his swearing-in ceremony. Whereas in 2014, he had invited South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, that is the SAARC leaders. The message was clear. India viewed Pakistan as a hindrance to SAARC and therefore wanted to encourage an alternate regional cooperation mechanism. August 5, 2019, the BJP-led National Democratic Alliance, that is the NDA government, decided to revoke Article 370 and 35A and bifurcated the then state of Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. The US and the European Union urged India to uphold human rights and restore normalcy in Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistan reacted by recalling its ambassador and sending back India's envoy. China and Pakistan tried to get India censured at the United Nations Security Council, but the move fell through. September 22, 2019, the Howdy Modi event in Texas was a defining moment in Indo-US ties. For the first time, an Indian Prime Minister and a US President jointly addressed the Indian community in the United States. Despite the growing ties, the US government sent a strong message to India on the trade deficit, data localization and e-commerce norms. US President Donald Trump also offered to mediate between India and Pakistan. October 11, 2019, India and China held their second informal summit in Mahabalipuram. Modi and Xi Jinping spent 6 hours with each other over 2 days. Both sides decided to set up a high-level mechanism to address the $58 billion trade deficit between the two countries. November 4, 2019, the trade deficit with China was one of the main reasons India pulled out of the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, that is the RCEP. The PMO decided joining the RCEP would not be in the best interest of India's pharma or its micro, small and medium enterprises. December 13, 2019, India and Japan postponed a summit-level meeting between Modi and Shinzo Abe after massive protests in Guwahati and other regions in the northeast over the passage of the Citizenship Amendment Act, which covers only non-Muslim refugees. The Bangladesh Foreign Minister also cancelled his India visit amidst concerns over the law finding voice in Dhaka. So this is it from this episode of The Handshake. For more such videos, keep watching MyNation.